Greetings all, the Devious Monkey here. It's another sunny Saturday out and I am on another adventure. Not nearly as fun as going and getting puppies, of course, but since Virginia Beach decided to get all cold and shit, and it's actually supposed to snow and we could get up to like 5 to 8 inches in a couple of days, reluctantly, I realized that I need a proper set of gloves. Now the ones that I bought, two, three years ago, I got them and they were awesome and they fell out of the damn pocket of my jacket and I didn't realize it. It's rare that I lose stuff and I lost those and I was bummed. So I went back to Amazon to buy them again and they were no longer available. So I had to buy something similar. Similar, they were not. They sucked. And I don't know if I've cut that out of my videos recently or not, but they're horrible. They don't keep my fingers or my hands warm at all. They soak up any moisture and it gets wet and then it gets even colder. And the grip, the stuff that's on it, supposed to be grippy, is actually extra slippery. So every time I'm touching a camera and holding one of my many devices, switch pod, any tripod, whatever, I'm convinced that I'm gonna drop it. And it freaks me out. So I have this set of old like liners that I got. It has proper little nubby things on the bottom, which is great. Years ago, I cut the fingers off and decided that would be great. It is, it's much better not having the fingers because they were too small anyways, but they are unraveling. And I don't want to heat them up with a lighter because then it gets hard and plasticky and then it sucks and I'll just ruin them. So I'd rather just have them unraveling until I can find a proper pair. Now, I did go back onto Amazon and look through freaking 3,000 pairs of gloves and decided that I found a pair that I could probably deal with. Problem is, I'm not gonna get them probably until after we get this 8 inches of snow. So I thought, okay, there's gotta be some place I can get freaking gloves locally. I mean, geez, there just has to be. So I decided that I would go to REI, thinking that, hey, the outdoor place ought to have something, really good. Wrong, they didn't have shit. So hopped in the truck and I just went to the mall, went to the Dick's Sporting Goods, and they had even less. So I'm done. I'm just gonna go home and order a pair off of Amazon, hopefully getting them before they become absolutely essential, and then, whatever. Now I'm heading down to the Vibe District, probably go to Three Ships, take a couple of pictures, maybe film some stuff, and we'll see what goes from there. I don't plan on doing too much else today, just because I just feel like chilling. And it's Van Gogh night, so I gotta be done by 8 anyways. The other thing that I decided for sure is that I'm selling the ZV-1. I am going to put, the actual, hey, I'm selling my ZV-1, here's what comes with it, on my Twitter, which is, of course, @TheDeviousMonkey. Just go there, check out my Twitter. If you're not following me and you feel like it, you can follow me. I don't care, but that's where it's gonna be described. Basically, everything that I'm selling is the ZV-1 itself, the small rig cage, the JJC 52mm lens adapter, the Zomai wide-angle lens, the small rig handle that goes at the top, and the screen protector that's on it that works for polarized lenses. All that cost me $1,000 when I bought it a few months ago with tax, shipping, and all that kind of stuff. It's about $1,000. I want 700. First person to send me $700, I'll ship it to you. Lower 48. I've said this before. I'm only shipping to the US, lower 48. If you want my ZV-1 and all that stuff that comes with it, message me and we'll talk about it. But the main thing will be on my Twitter, @TheDeviousMonkey, which will also be linked in the description down below. Don't get me wrong, I love this camera. It's a great camera. It's been a lot of fun. But now that I'm using the A6600 main Cinerig and second A6600, which I thought I was just gonna use for stills, but now I'm actually using it for more of my run and gun stuff, I like that better. Oh, and now that I got that 10-18 lens, it's cinched. I will probably never pick this up again. So there's no point in this just sitting here rotting. I really want it to go to somebody that's excited and passionate about creating, and they've been looking for this, but they don't wanna spend $1,000. I'm not gonna haggle with anybody. If I don't get $700, it sits here and I'll play with it occasionally. I'm not entertaining offers. I don't want to hear any low balls or any of that shit. $700, You know what you're getting, you know it's a deal, and that's it. And I'm not gonna argue and go back and forth with anybody about it. You bought it, it's yours, that's it. No tradesy backsies, no buyer's remorse, okay? Sorry to be a dick about it, but I hate selling stuff online because of the idiots that come out of the woodwork. And I just don't wanna deal with that. So $700 and it's yours. The next thing is just, I have gotten really busy with my day job. And change has been coming. They've been talking about it for a while now, but we've had a series of calls this week that, like, that's it, change is coming, which means I'm gonna be busy. And that means that I might not be able to post on a daily basis. I love daily vlogging. Since I got back into the groove, I totally dig it. I love doing this. I love making videos. I'm still looking to up my game. I've learned about multicam. Well, I'm learning about multicam and trying to figure out how to make it smoother in my editing and so on and so forth. And I think I think I'm getting there. The other thing is the fact that last night I finally committed to doing something that I've been thinking about doing for a while, and that is that I bought a year membership to Storyblocks. This is not a paid promotion. I haven't even used it yet. I just set up my account and paid for it, and I'm hoping that that will allow me to create more entertaining and engaging videos, because one, I don't have drones, two, I don't have pirate ships, three, I don't, you know, travel around the world, blah, 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 you get what I'm saying. So I know that Storyblocks has a ton of stuff and that it is possible to make videos entirely of Storyblocks stock footage, but I don't wanna do that. I just wanna sort of spice things up a little bit. And I've been talking about that, how I wanna up my game and start telling better stories and so on and so forth. And for me, I felt that using Storyblocks was the next step. So again, this is what this channel is all about. It's all about me figuring out how to be a decent filmmaker or a content creator or a storyteller while dealing with the shit of life. And for me, the shit is my evil, angry spine. So that's it. I just sort of give you the rundown of what's been going on, what's happening, where I'm going, why I'm going there, what I plan on in the future, maybe, we'll see. But for now, it's day by day. When I finish tomorrow, that will be January. That'll be 31 days in a row that I've posted a video, because I said I was gonna daily vlog. I would like to try to keep that up, but as of after tomorrow, no promises that there's gonna be a video every day. It will bother the shit out of me if I can't post a video. That's how I get when I start doing this. I love doing it and I love keeping that flow going, but if I have too much to do with my day job, then something's gotta give. It isn't like I can just do this in 10 minutes, so it is very involved, and because I speak like crap and I gotta cut a lot of shit out, it takes even longer. Nothing crazy today, just sort of like an end of the week wrap up. Just wanted to keep you posted. If you're interested in the ZV-1, let me know or go check it out on my Twitter. Everything will be linked down below. If you have any questions, comments, suggestions, leave them down below. As always, thank you for joining me. Like, subscribe, and all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.